السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي هدى، والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، خصوصا على سيد الرسل وخاتم الأنبياء وعلى آله وأصحابه الذين اجتبى. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وإذ أخذنا ميثاقكم ورفعنا فوقكم الطور، خذوا ما آتيناكم بقوة واذكروا ما فيه لعلكم تتقون. ثم توليتم من بعد ذلك، فلولا فضل الله عليكم ورحمته لكنتم من الخاسرين. ولقد علمتم الذين اعتدوا منكم في السبت فقلنا لهم كونوا قردة خاسئين. فجعلناها نكالا لما بين يديها وما خلفها وموعظة للمتقين. صدق الله العظيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in these ayahs of Surah Al-Baqarah, is reminding us of a very important responsibility of ours as believers, and that is خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ. Whatever we have given you, take it strongly. All the ahkam of the sharia that came to you, every message that came to you from Rabbul Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala, every message that came to you from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ, take it very strongly and firmly. Don't be hesitant in following the orders of Allah and the orders of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Have no doubt about what Allah is telling you and what the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is promising you. خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ, take it very strongly. And this order is not given to us only. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us it was given to the previous nations too. They were told, خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ, take the book of Allah seriously, take it strongly, take it firmly. Don't show any hesitation, any doubts, and any weakness in following the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Unfortunately, when we look at the ones that are supposed to be preaching the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way deen is presented this day is as if we are from the beginning telling people, you don't have to be strong in following deen. Take it very lightly. Don't be firm. Take it very lightly. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us in a hadith, إِنَّ هَذَا الدِّينَ بَدَأَ غَرِيبًا وَسَيَعُودُ كَمَا بَدَأَ. This hadith in Sahih Muslim, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when this deen started, it was very strange for people. وَسَيَعُودُ كَمَا بَدَأَ, soon a time would come when this deen would be as strange as it was in the beginning. Let's quickly look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us in these ayahs of Surah Al-Baqarah, and then we'll come back to this hadith. خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةِ Whatever we have given you, take it firmly, strongly, hold strongly to all the orders of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاسْمَعُوا And listen to what I have to tell you. This is what Allah is telling us. قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا The previous nation's reply was, okay, we heard what you are saying, Ya Allah. We heard your message. We heard your book. But we can't follow it. سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا We heard it, but we cannot obey it. We cannot follow it. Sorry, Ya Allah. I can't do it. Not necessarily that all of those people say it in these words that عَصَيْنَا I don't want to follow. But their actions proved that they are saying عَصَيْنَا We don't want to follow it. سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا We heard it. We have seen your book, Ya Allah. We read your book. We heard your book. We got the message of your book. But, sorry, I can't do it. This order is difficult. Over here, I have a reason for not doing. On the third order, it's not in accordance with my time. The fourth one doesn't make sense to me, وَلَيَّازُ بِاللَّهِ I'm using my common sense and it doesn't make any sense. We have reasons and ways for not following the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what asayna means. Sami'na, we heard what you are saying, Ya Allah, but asayna, we can't follow it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأُشْرِبُوا فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْعِجْلَ بِكُفْرِهِمْ Because of their disbelief, although they were claiming the iman, Allah is talking about the people that were considered to be the people of Iman. Because of their disbelief in Allah. وَأُشْرِبُوا فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْعِجْلِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I put the love of the calf in their hearts. And of course, Quran is a miraculous word. Each and every word is miraculous of Quran. How beautifully Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained how much this love went into their heart. The love of a calf. How much did it go into their heart? The word Allah used in Quran is ushribu. I'm sure many of us can understand the word shariba. What does it mean? To drink. Shariba is to drink. Now, take a glass. Put some rocks in the glass. Until there is no more room to put any more rocks in the glass. So you can say the glass is full, in reality is not full. Take some small pebbles and try to put them into the glass. They will make the room around the rocks and they will get into the glass. Now, you may take some dust, some dirt, and put it into the glass. That dirt will make its way into the glass, which means there is still room in the glass. But no more pebbles can go there. But dirt can go in there. After that, you may think it's full, but put some liquid in it. And this liquid will make the room in the glass. Will still find some room in the glass. This liquid will force out any bubbles, any airs that are in there, will take it out and will make the room and stay in the glass. The thing that would really sip into something totally and fully is liquid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأُشْرِبُوا فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْعِجْلَ بِكُفْرِهِمْ In their heart, this love of the calf went just like a liquid that forces all the bubbles, everything out and filled their hearts with the love of that calf. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith, لِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ عِجْلٌ يَعْبُدُونَ For every nation, there is a calf that they worship, وَعِجْلُ أُمَّتِي الْمَالِ The calf of my ummah is wealth. The calf of this ummah is wealth. وَأُشْرِبُوا فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْعِجْلَ بِكُفْرِهِمْ Because of their disbelief, which means because of saying to Allah, عَصَيْنَا Ya Allah, we heard your book, but we are not ready to follow it. I'm not ready yet. There are orders that are difficult for me. I can't do them yet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, because of this, أُشْرِبُوا فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْعِجْلَ بِكُفْرِهِمْ Their hearts were filled with the liquid, with the love that went in the form of a liquid in their hearts that filled the whole hearts. When in every corner of the heart, didn't leave any corner out. قُلْ بِئْسَ مَا يَأْمُرُكُمْ بِهِ إِيمَانُكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ Tell them, what's your iman? If you think that you are believers, then your iman, what iman is teaching you is very bad. If then your iman, that you think you are a mu'min, and you think that your iman is teaching you, that you can tell Allah, I'm not ready to do it. I'm not willing to do it. I have a reason for not doing it. What type of iman is that? And this is why in another ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us. After the similar ayahs, وَإِذَا خَذْنَا مِيثَاقَكُمْ وَرَفَعْنَا فَوْقَكُمُ الطُّورِ خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ وَاذْكُرُوا مَا فِيهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ We gave you this covenant. We gave you my book and وَرَفَعْنَا فَوْقَكُمُ الطُّورِ And we put the mountain of Tur to be hanging over you. خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ Whatever we have given you, take it very strongly. وَاذْكُرُوا مَا فِيهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ And keep on talking about what's in the book. That was a responsibility. وَذْكُرُوا مَا فِيهِ Keep on talking about what's in this book. Conveying the message of Allah that is in the book to others is our responsibility. وَذْكُرُوا مَا فِيهِ Keep on talking about your book. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ So that you may live the life of taqwa. The ayahs are beautiful and the message continues. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right in the next ayah tells us about the very same nation when they started finding excuses. The next ayah tells us about وَلَقَدْ عَلِمْتُمُ الَّذِينَ اَعْتَدَوْا مِنْكُمْ فِي السَّبْتِ You know how the people of Sabat made an excuse. And we all know it from Quran very briefly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them they were not allowed to fish on Saturdays. That was their Sabat. They were not allowed to fish. Now, on Saturdays, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make a lot of fish come up there. Rest of the days, no fish. إِسْتَعْدُونَ فِي السَّبْتِ إِذْ يَعْدُونَ فِي السَّبْتِ إِذْ تَأْتِيهِمْ حَيْتَانُهُمْ يَوْمَ سَبْتِهِمْ شُرَّعَ وَيَوْمَ لَا يَسْبِتُونَ لَا تَأْتِيهِمْ Saturdays, a lot of fish. Rest of the 6 days, standing there all day with the hook, no fish. So they said, you know, it's getting too difficult. Saturdays, you see so much fish. There has to be a way for us to get those fish. It was a test from Rabbul Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now you see a lot of fish over there. Rest of the days, all the fish are gone. So they started making holes over there around the ocean. Make all the fish get into the hole, block it so the fish won't be able to go back. Next day, Sunday, go and pick it up. Well, I didn't pick it up on Saturday. I wasn't fishing on Saturday. But she trapped it on Saturday. You made that hole so the fish will get in there and then you close the hole, you trap the fish, and you come and pick it up on Sunday. Really, in reality, you caught the fish on Saturday. It was in your control on Saturday. Excuses. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, because of this, فَبِمَا نَقْضِهِمْ مِيثَاقَهُمْ لَعَنَّاهُمْ We curse them. قُلْنَا لَهُمْ كُنُوا قِرَدَةً خَاسِئِينَ We turned them into monkeys. It was because of making excuses for not following the awamir and the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is advising us. That make sure you don't make the same mistake. Don't get into the same situation. Don't put yourself into the same place where you will be making excuses. You see a lot of benefit at some place. Yes, a lot of money. I can see a lot of benefit there. But it's haram. Oh yeah, okay. You know, we find a reason. We find a way of making it halal. This is exactly what they were doing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ Take it very seriously, take it very strongly, be very firm when it comes to my orders and the ways of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informs us that this deen when it started at the early stages. When I started introducing deen to people, it was very strange. A sahabi would be at his home trying to do salah and everyone is giving him that strange look. What are you doing? He cannot perform salah within his own home. Within the four walls of his own house, he cannot do the salah. He cannot perform wudu. A person came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, became Muslim, went back to his home. His father-in-law was the leader of the clan. So therefore, he didn't want to tell his wife anything. But every time for salah, he would make wudu and perform salah. The wife thought that he is crazy. She went and complained to her father that I see him every day. He starts, wakes up in the morning and started washing up in a way, in a strange way. I don't know, what does he do? Every morning I see him, he washes his hands up to his elbows, he's washing his face, he's washing his feet. Something is strange. And then, not only this, after he does that, then he stands up, he goes down and he stands up and he goes down. Something is wrong with him. Maybe the effect of jinn or something, I don't know. You need to treat him. So the father-in-law approaches him, asked him, what are you doing? My daughter was complaining that something is wrong. Are you affected by jinn or something wrong with you? Believe me, when you read this hadith, it's so amazing that these days so many people want to bring their youth, their children, their daughters to the masjid, to the imam, and have the same complaint. Maybe some jinn has affected my child because she always wants to just wear hijab and she's always reading and reading Quran. There must be some effect of the jinn. You take the jinn away so she won't read Quran. Our youth today, they are strangers in their own homes. They can't make wudu within their homes. They can't perform salah within their homes. A young man goes to his house. The mother sees there is a mark of a cap on his head. I know you don't wear that basketball cap. You don't wear that. I know this. So you must have gone to masjid. This is the reality. You must have gone to the masjid. There is a sign of a cap on your head, which means you went to the masjid. Make sure next time I don't want to see any cap on your head. Inna al-Islam abada ghariba. When this deen started, it was very strange for people. Wa sayyaudu kama abada. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, soon a time would come when deen will be considered as strange as it was in the beginning and early days. You make wudu, people will look at you. People will be staring at you. What are you doing? You put your foot in the sink? You wash your foot? Why do you need to wash your foot for? Subhanallah. Washing the foot, this became strange. Walking out of the bathroom straight out without washing the hands and then eating anything with the same hand is not strange. The person would walk out, will pull out an apple out of his bag and is eating with the same hand. He went to the bathroom. And there was any water in the bathroom? No, there is no water in the bathroom. At least we can think maybe he washed his hand in the bathroom. No. So he didn't wash himself in the bathroom. And in public places, the only time a person goes into the bathroom, when he wants to go for number two. For number one, there is urinals. He will stand up and do it. Simply means he used napkins. Now he's telling us his hands are not dirty. And then he walks out of there and straight out. And then he pulls the apple out and is eating it. And when he sees someone washing his feet, he's telling them that this is dirty. You're washing your foot. Subhanallah. Washing the foot is being dirty. Eating the apple with that extra flour is not dirt. It's still being clean. Being normal. إِنَّ الدِّينَ بَدَأَ غَرِيبًا. When this deen started, it was very strange for people. What are you guys doing? Why are you bowing down? I don't see an idol in front of you. You're bowing down for who? I said, for Allah. Sahaba were hiding in the mountains to go and do salah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to hide in his house to do the salah. He used to go in the middle of the night to go and perform salat tajjud by the Kaaba. If they see him during the daytime, they will mock him. They will make fun of him. What are you doing? Who are you praying to? إِنَّ الدِّينَ بَدَى غَرِيبًا. Everything was strange about it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, soon my ummah situation will be the same. Those who would follow the deen, they will be considered strangers. Now, the choice would be for the ummah, either be a stranger for others and follow what Allah says and what His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says. The second choice is, no, be like what everyone else thinks, being a normal person. Be what everyone else will think is a normal. You are normal. You are normal means that you don't cover your whole body. A woman doesn't cover the body. A man has to cover it. But a woman is supposed to wear some shorts. It's hot. And you are wearing this black thing on you. Subhanallah, as if the dress was only for the weather. Alhamdulillah, we are in Buffalo. We are still safe. But subhanallah, all of these things, now strangers are those women who cover themselves, they are strange. And the one, as much as you show others, this is how good you are. As much as you uncover your body, this is how nice of a dress you are wearing, and you will get all sorts of admirations that she was dressed so nice. And for every woman to get that admiration, she tries to keep herself as naked as she could. She would cut it as short as possible. Even the day when you feel like wearing long one, make sure it's so thin that it's see-through. And then now zippers on the pant. So you open the whole pant. It's not just a small zip. It's from the toe till the knee, till your hip, all the way. A person sitting in the masjid, I'm not joking, a person sitting in the masjid. And I looked around, buttons on the paint. All buttons all over. And of course, when you have buttons on the distance of 5 inches away from each other, it opens up. And it's sitting in the masjid. Why people are wearing all of these type of dresses? Which to me and you may be strange, but this is so that they would be considered normal people in the society. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and quickly let's see what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَطُوبَ لِلْغُرَبَى. He says, good news for the strangers of those days. This was really enough when he says, good news. On the day of judgment, we would just go and say, Ya Rasulullah, you said there is good news for me. What is that good news? If he says, I give you a candy, well, this is not good news on the Akhirah. And the Akhirah good news means, now you help me, I have to go to Jannah. Anything less than that, I'm not accepting it. فَطُوبَ لِلْغُرَبَى. Imam Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah, has narrated, Tuba is the name of a special tree in Jannah that will be given to these type of people. Which means these people for sure will go into Jannah and will go to the high position where that tree is. Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah narrates, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَطُوبَ لِلْغُرَبَى, good news to those strangers of those days. Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhi majma'in asked, وَمَنْ هُمْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Ya Rasulullah, then tell us, who will be the strangers in those days? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الْفَرَّارُونَ بِدِينِهِمْ. Those who would be running away from people to save their deen, to protect their deen, to safeguard their iman. They are trying to stay away from people. الْفَرَّارُونَ بِدِينِهِمْ. They are going away from people, they are staying away, and people consider them strange. Why are you just staying away from everyone? Why you are being so secluded? Continuously people are asking those questions. Why you keep yourself so secluded? No, we are not. But it's only that when people see us doing salah, when they hear the adhan, we hear these things, they feel that this is strange and we don't want to associate with these type of people. In another hadith, narrated by Ibn Majah rahimahullah in his sunan, on the authority of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, he says, when we asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who are the ghuraba, ya Rasulullah? Who will be those strangers, ya Rasulullah? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, النُزَّاعُ مِنَ الْقَبَائِلِ. Those who would just come from different clans and different places get together for my ibadah. and they left their clans, they left their communities, they left everything for my sake because they were considered strangers in their own communities within their own families. They had to leave their family and be with strangers, with others that would treat them like family because they were doing the ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala together. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahimahullah narrates in his Musnad on the authority of Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu anhu. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about these ghuraba, the strangers of these days. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Unasun salihun fi unasin su'in kathir." Few virtuous people within a lot of people who don't want to do anything good. Fi unasin su'in kathir. Within a lot of people who are not ready to follow the deen. مَنْ يَعْصِهِمْ أَكْثَرُ مِمَّنْ يُطِيعُهُمْ. There are more people to disobey them than the ones who listen to them and who would go with them. Not only this, Imam Tabrani rahimahullah have narrated in his Mu'jam on the authority of Abu Umama al-Bahili radiyallahu anhu. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhi majma'in that when we started, we were considered strangers to everyone. He says, now alhamdulillah, the deen have spread and a lot of people have accepted Islam. Then he says to Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhi majma'in, if you look at our situation these days, now he's talking when he's Medina and a lot of people have embraced Islam and people are really learning the deen. So he says to Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhi majma'in, if you look at our situation in these days, that we would see that most of the clans, most of the communities, they all are learning about the deen. They have good information, good knowledge about deen. Except with one or two people, munafiqeen and those type of people in that community who don't want to learn it and no one wants to listen to them, no one cares about them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, but a time would come when the situation would be totally opposite. The situation of the ummah would be totally opposite. وَإِنَّ مِنْ إِدْبَارِ هَذَا الدِّينِ. The sign when this deen is going out of people's life. إِدْبَارُ الدِّينِ. Deen is turning away. Deen is going away from people's life. أَنْ تَجْفُ الْقَبِيلَةُ بِأَسْرِهَا. That the whole clan will have no knowledge, no information about deen. فَلَا يَبْقَى فِيهِ إِلَّا الْفَقِيهُ أَوِ الْفَقِيهَانِ. There is only one person who has some knowledge. One or two people in a community who have some knowledge. Their situation, فَهُمَا ذَلِيلَانِ. They are humiliated within the community. No one wants to talk to them. إِن تَكَلَّمَا قُهِرَ. If they speak, people make them stay quiet. People tell them, you can't talk. We don't want you to speak to us. إِن تَكَلَّمَا قُهِرَ وَالطُّهِدَ. And they will be forced to stay away and not to say anything. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, this is a sign of إدبار الدين. What do we see around us? How many people in our society, in the community we can see, and of our families we see, who are really learned about deen and who know what deen is all about? Who can tell us even the basic things about Islam? This is the time of idbar al-deen. Deen is just rowing away. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhi majma'in, إِنَّ مِنْ وَرَائِكُمْ أَيَّامُ الصَّبْرِ. Days would come after you people, after you, after the Sahaba. Time would come when it will be really the time of sabr for the people of Iman. لِلْعَامِلِ فِيهِمْ أَجْرُ خَمْسِينَ مِنْكُمْ. A person who would practice deen in those days will get the reward of 50 people amongst you. They said, بَلْ مِنْهُمْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Ya Rasulullah, no, did you mean 50 people of their own people? He said, no, بَلْ مِنْكُمْ. 50 people of you, of the Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in. Of course, this is the good news now for al-ghuraba. Amazing. Just think how much reward we can get in these days, but how to get it, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith narrated by Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, these ghuraba will be, their sign will be, الَّذِينَ يُحْيُونَ سُنَّتِي وَيُعَلِّمُونَهَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. Those who would bring my sunnahs back to life. Those who would bring my sunnahs back to life, and they will teach others the ways of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The sunnahs of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu, once he got up in the masjid, and he made this announcement to his students and to all the tabi'een. Of course, this is now, mostly people are after the time of tabi'een. Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu says to them, الغرباء في الدنيا أربعة. He says there are four strangers in this world. There are four types of strangers in this dunya. Now, if we were to think about them, who are those? For us, maybe a person, a new person in the society, he's a stranger, no one knows him. This is why we all consider him a stranger. And in this society, of course, we see the strangers are those who are following the deen of Allah. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu says, الغرباء في الدنيا أربعة قرآن في جوف ظالم. Quran is a stranger that is in the heart or in the house of a wrongdoer who doesn't want to read it, doesn't want to recite it, doesn't want to learn it, doesn't want to practice it. This Quran is considered to be a stranger in this house. Imagine in a house where Quran is forbidding so many things that are within this house, within the four walls of the house. There are 1,000 items that are haram in accordance with the Quran. And Quran is on the shelf and we are doing all of those things. So Quran is very strange, a stranger in our houses. Number 2. وَمَسْجِدٌ فِي نَادِي قَوْمٍ لَا يُصَلُّونَ فِيهِ. A masjid in a community where people don't want to pray in that masjid. People, no one is there for salah. This masjid is a stranger. Masjid is inviting people. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. No one wants to answer the masjid. Say everyone considers it a stranger. I don't know who this is. I have to go to a club. I have to go to the store. I have to go to the mall. I have to go to other places. This masjid is considered a stranger amongst those people. Number 3. مصحف في بيت لا يقرأ فيه. And a Quran that is in the houses. But people are not reciting it. The first one was in the heart. This is in the house. A copy of the Quran. No one wants to read it, recite it. Number 4. رَجُلٌ صَالِحٌ مَعَ قَوْمٍ سُوءٍ. A virtuous person who is following the deen amongst those who don't want to practice it. They consider him a stranger. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam therefore tells us, when that time comes, when people of deen, people who perform salah, people who would practice their deen, wudu, salah, hijab, beard, sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, at a time when these things will be considered strange things amongst people, if you follow my sunnahs, you keep my sunnahs alive, you would get the reward of 50 sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in, of the amal of 50 sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in. Who doesn't want that reward? Of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have opened the doors of opportunity, but the choice we have to make is, do I want to stay in the society, being just like a normal person, a common person, or familiar person to everyone, doing everything according to what people think is normal, or I don't care if people consider me a stranger, but I want to follow the deen and I want to follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to follow the deen, follow the sharia, follow the sunnahs of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, especially the sunnahs that have been neglected. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to bring those sunnahs back to life. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.